हाय एवरीवन, टुडे टॉपिक इज डिफरेंसेस बिटवीन पीसीएम पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन डेल्टा मॉड्यूलेशन अडैप्टिव डेल्टा मॉड्यूलेशन डिफरेंशियल पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन डेल्टा मॉड्यूलेशन अडैप्टिव डेल्टा मॉड्यूलेशन डिफरेंशियल पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन पैरामीटर्स ऑफ कंपैरिजंस नंबर ऑफ बिट्स लेवल्स एंड स्टेप साइज क्वांटाइजेशन एरर एंड डिस्टॉर्शन ट्रांसमिशन बैंडविड्थ फीडबैक कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ implementation. These are the different parameters to compare the PCM, DM, ADM and DPCM. Number of bits. In PCM, it can be used 4, 8 or 16 bits per sample. 4, 8 or 16 bits per sample. In DM, it is uses only 1 bit. 1 bit for 1 sample. 1 bit for 1 sample. In ADM, it is uses only 1 bit for 1 sample. In differential pulse code modulation, bits can be more than 1 but are less than 1 p less than PCM. Next one is levels and step size. Levels and step size. The number of in PCM, the number of levels depends on number of bits. The number of levels will depends on number of bits. Level size is fixed in PCM system. Level size is fixed, or it is divided continuous time signals to the equal samples. In DM, step size is kept fixed and cannot be varied. In this also, step size is fixed and it cannot be varied. In ADM, according to the signal variation, step size varies means, that means as per required we can change the step sizes. Next one is DPCM. Number of levels is fixed. Next, quantization error distortion. In PCM, quantization error depends on number of levels used. Quantization means it will split the continuous time signal to the step by step. That's why quantization error depends on number of levels used. In DM, slope overload distortion and granular noise are present. Adaptive delta modulation, quantization noise present but other errors are absent. In DPCM, slope overload, that means step size up and downs, slope overload, distortion and quantization noise is present. Transmission bandwidth. In PCM, highest bandwidth is required. That means high bandwidth is required since numbers of bits are high. So number size is high, then automatically it will be used high bandwidth. In DM, lowest bandwidth is required. Why? Because the number levels are low. lowest bandwidth is required. Next one is ADM, lowest bandwidth is required. DM and ADM is almost parameters are similarities or equal parameters. Next one is DPCM, bandwidth requires is less than PCM. Bandwidth requires is less than PCM. Next one is feedback. There is no feedback in transmitter or receiver. That means feedback means the signal will propagate continuously from source to destination. If errors are eliminated and continuously process the signals from source to destination without distortion. By using feedback, it will resend the signals from input side and eliminate the errors, and then after corrected signal will propagate to the output side. So in PCM there is no feedback device are used or not used. In DM feedback exists in transmit. In delta modulation feedback network or device may be used. In adaptive delta modulation is also used feedback exists. In DPCM also used feedback exists. Next one is complexity of implementation. In PCM system is complex. In PCM system is complex equal. Next DM, ADM and DPCM all are simple. That means the overall process of either pulse code modulation or delta modulation or adaptive delta modulation or differential pulse code modulation, any pulse code modulation, delta modulation, adaptive delta modulation and DPCM, only it has uses three major parameters to convert the signals from one source to one place to another place, or one block to another block: sampler, quantizer and coding devices, either encoding or decoding. These are the three major blocks which will use it to convert the signals is in the form of digital. Once again I will repeat, sampler is a circuit which is receives the continuous sine signals and then after it will be divided into sampling signals. That means a continuous sine signal will be converted is in the form of discrete signal. That means it will assigning equal intervals and then after it will be passing through the quantization, and quantizations are used for to convert the discrete signals to the discrete time signals to the digital signal. That means it will assigning some digital information data to the signal. And encoding or decoding are identifying the code information and then after it will converts different forms. So in any conversion method, in any conversion method or pulse code modulation, delta modulation, adaptive delta modulation, differential delta modulation, so differential pulse code modulation are majorly used three major parameters: sampler, quantizer and encoding and decoding. So by using these are all we can easily find out the major parameters of number of bits, how many bits are used and levels and step size, quantization error and distortion, transmission bandwidth, feedback process, complexity of implementation means the system, which type of signals will be required. Is it either analog or digital, it will verify, and then after it will be passing through the output side. So these are the major differences between PCM delta, PCM DM, ADM and DPCM. Thank you.